Welcome, dear students, to today's session of Summit for Max. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for further notifications. Let's get started. In today's session of integrations, we are going to see the properties of definite integrals. The first property says that integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of t dt. Second property, we have integral a to b f of x dx is equal to minus integral b to a f of x dx. The third property says that integral a to b f of x plus or minus u of x into dx can be written as integral a to b f of x dx plus or minus integral a to b g of x dx. The fourth property says integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to c f of x dx plus integral c to b f of x dx. Fifth property is integral 0 to a f of x dx is equal to integral 0 to a f of a minus x into dx. Sixth property says that if f of x is an even function, integral minus a to a f of x dx can be written as 2 times integral 0 to a f of x dx, and if f of x is odd function, then integral minus a to a f of x dx is equal to 0. And the seventh property is integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of a plus b minus x into dx. Using these properties, let us solve few problems. Here we are given integral minus pi by 4 to pi by 4 x cube cos cube x into dx. Here we have f of x as x cube cos cube x. So f of minus x is minus x the whole cube into cos cube of minus x, so which will give you minus x cube into cos cube x. Because cos x is an even function, which implies f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. We know the property that if f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, then f of x is an odd function. Therefore, by the property given above, we see that integral minus a to a f of x dx is equal to 0 if f of x is an odd function. Therefore, integral minus pi by 4 to pi by 4 x cube cos cube x dx is equal to 0. The second problem we have is integral minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 sine square theta d theta. Here f of theta is equal to sine square theta. F of minus theta is equal to sine squared of minus theta, which is minus sine theta the whole square. So we get sine squared theta, which is f of theta. F of minus theta is equal to f of theta implies that f of theta is an even function. By the property, integral minus a to a f of x dx is equal to 2 times integral 0 to a f of x dx if f of x is an even function. So we can write integral minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 sine square theta d theta as 2 times integral 0 to pi by 2 sine square theta d theta. Here we are going to substitute sine square theta as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Two times integral of 0 to pi by 2, 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 into d theta. The 2 in the numerator and denominator gets cancelled. And we get integral 0 to pi by 2, 1 minus cos 2 theta into d theta. So integrating we get theta minus sine 2 theta by 2. Within the limit 0 to pi by 2. Substituting the upper and lower limits, we get pi by 2 minus sine of 2 times pi by 2 by 2. Minus the lower limits makes the function 0. So we have pi by 2 minus sine pi whole divided by 2. We know that sine pi is equal to 0. So the answer is pi by 2. The last problem of today's session is integral minus 1 to 1 log of 2 minus x by 2 plus x into dx. The function f of x can be written as log of 2 minus x minus log 2 plus x. And f of minus x is log of 2 minus of minus x minus log of 2 minus x, which is log of 2 plus x by 2 minus x, which is actually the reciprocal of f of x. So f of minus x is equal to minus f of x. F of minus x is equal to minus f of x implies that f of x is an odd function. Therefore, integral minus 1 to 1 log of 2 minus x by 2 plus x dx is equal to 0. That's the answer. Hope the session was interesting. For much more, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.